depositor table. The description here given is that bank has many branches and n number of customers. What attribute customer has? Customer name attribute, customer street, and customer city. Table has branch name, branch city, and assets. Account attribute has, account table has account name, account number, branch name, balance, balance, and branch. Loan table has loan number, branch name, amount. That's it, amount. Depositor has customer name, account number. Customer number, that's it. These are different tables used in the bank database. Customer can open different kinds of accounts with bank. The bank keeps track of a customer by his SSN, name, address, and phone number. Age is used factor to check whether he is a major or not, above 18 or not. There are different types of loans, each identified by a loan number. The customer take out more than one type of loan and all branches can give loans. Loans have duration and interest rate. The account holder can inquire about balance in his account. Answer for the following. During following, you have to write queries for following. Select star. First, we have to create tables.
Yeah, create a customer table, branch table, account table, loan table, and depositor table. Five tables you need to create here. Here we are creating customer table, customer having attributes like customer name, customer street, here customer name, where care, comma primary key, syntax is wrong, check once. Here while you are creating, explain once if you created all tables, what are the attributes, what are the data types we have used, what is the relation between the child table to parent table, primary key relation, parent relation, you can explain, and sometimes what we have used, what is the use of not null units in primary key and all. One by one. Just first create the tables, then you can start. Here, explain that attributes and tables and all relations.
We have created a five tables here for bank database. First table is customer table, in which customer name, customer street, and customer city are the attributes, varchar data type, and not null.
Go for the queries, there you can explain, because here we cannot see the primary key foreign key relation, right?
Customer name is okay. So one. In customer table, customer name is the primary key, and three attributes, customer name and customer street and customer city, are there in the customer table. All are varchar data types. Customer name is the primary key. In branch table, branch name, branch city and assets are the attribute, in which branch name is the primary key. Account table, in account table, account. In account table, account number, branch name, balance are the attributes, in which account number is the primary key, and we have one foreign key here, branch name, which is related to the branch table, branch name. Thank you. in loan table, loan number, branch name and amount are the attributes. We have a foreign key. Branch name is the foreign key, which is referred to the branch table branch name. In depositor table, customer name, account number are the attributes. Primary key is customer name and account number, both are primary keys. Foreign keys, customer name referred to the customer table, customer name is the first foreign key, and we have another foreign key also, account number, which is referred to the account table, account number, account table, the attribute account number. And last table, borrower as customer name, loan number as the attributes. Primary keys are customer name and loan number. Foreign key, both are primary keys and foreign key. Foreign key, customer name is referred to customer table, customer name. And loan number is referred to the loan table, loan number.
Insert the data into the tables. Into the data.
Thank you.
Yeah. Already it's 9:57. Okay, just you can explain what you have done till now. Why you are getting a primary key violation exception? In the tomorrow class, you can continue for remaining queries. Okay, just you can explain three here. Why you are getting violated primary key? What is the reason? Unmute yourself and then explain here. You are in mute.
Here I got a parent key not found because here I have written D capital, downtown D capital, but in branch table I have written downtown D small, so they are different, so it's showing integrity constraint parent key not found here. This is a error I got here.
The primary key table having the data only then we can the chain table can enter, otherwise we cannot enter the data. Whatever we are trying to insert data into chain table, so the data must available in the parent table, otherwise we cannot enter into the chain table because we'll get the primary key violation exception.
Here I am trying to enter the duplicate data, so I got a unique constraint because customer name is the primary key in this table, so you should it should be unique. I have tried to enter a duplicate two times. I have tried to enter zones, so I got this error, unique constraint violation.
Okay, see, yeah, in the tables. Okay, in the tomorrow session we are going to
okay.
All of you, you also make the tables ready for tomorrow's queries. Okay, I will ask the remaining persons to write the queries on the tables. So for that you need to create the tables already, right? So upload your document. I created another folder called DBMS lab practice bank database. There you can upload your document in Teams folder. Okay. Okay. Thanks for listening to the session. You can leave the session now. Thank you all.